In the previous part, we have learned to create this isometric object. Now, in this part, we will create and apply layers and apply dimensions. Link to previous tutorial is given in description. Let's start with this tutorial. Then next is to create these center lines. To create these center lines, we will create some layers. Click here on layer properties. Then click on new layer, name it as center, click outside, again click on new layer, name it as dim, because we are going to give dimensions also. Click outside, then assign color for 0, suppose we will choose this one, okay. Then for center, we will choose this one, number 18, okay. And for dimensions, we will choose this one, number 51, okay. Then for center, click here on continuous, click on load, click inside here, type C for center, click on OK, select center, OK. Then make center layer current, for that double click here. So here center layer got current. Then close this dialog box. Then type L, enter. Click on this endpoint, press enter. Then click on this line and convert its layer to center. Then click on this grip and click on this midpoint. Again, click on this endpoint and click on this midpoint. Press escape. Now here center line is not shown properly. To show it properly, we will have to change line type scale. Type LTS, enter and reduce scale. Suppose I will make it 0.2, enter. So here it is now properly visible. Then same way, we will have to create lines here also. Type L, enter, click on this endpoint, enter, enter, click on this center point or midpoint, and click on this endpoint, enter. One more is required here. L, enter, click here and here, press enter. So now the center lines are ready. Then next is to place dimensions. For that click here, make dim layer current. Then click here on dimension. Then take your cursor to this line, click. Now here it is showing horizontal or vertical dimension, but we want aligned. For aligned dimension, you will have to turn this ortho mode off. So here now it is showing aligned dimension. So click. Then again click on this line, take it below, click. Then click on this midpoint, and again this midpoint. Then here click on this endpoint, take it inside and click. Same way click on this line. Zoom there, click and click. Click on this endpoint, click on this endpoint, take it on this side and click. Then same way here, click, take it outside, click. So all the dimensions has been given. Only this 40 remained. So for that, click on this endpoint. Then make ortho on and take your cursor to this endpoint and track it. Now our plane is not correct. So click here and select isoplane left. Here now it is tracking perfectly. Click there and click on this endpoint. Press escape. So all the dimensions has been given. Now these dimensions are smaller. To increase size, type D, enter, click on modify, click on fit, then select this and make it 1.5. okay, close. So now these dimensions are properly visible. Then to align these dimensions, type dim edit. Here is dim edit, click on oblique. Then we want these three dimensions vertical, so select these three dimensions, press enter. Then we want vertical like this line, so click on this endpoint and this endpoint, so it will automatically take that angle. Again press enter, click on oblique, and select this dimension, and press enter. Then again obliquing angle will be this line. We want to align this extension line to this line, so click on this midpoint and this endpoint, so it will be aligned as per those line. Same way here, enter, oblique, select this dimension, enter. Obliquing angle will be as per this line, so click on this endpoint and this endpoint. So here it is aligned perfectly. Same way for this dimension, press enter, oblique, select this dimension, enter, click on this endpoint and this endpoint. So here it has been aligned perfectly. Then if you see here, this 75 is vertical but it is inclined. So to make them perfectly as per this drawing, we will have to create some textiles. For that, click here on annotation, click on textile, click on new, then name this textile as 30 because our oblique angle will be 30. Click on OK. Then make here 30, click on apply. Then again new, minus 30, okay. Then place here minus sign, apply. Now here actually it is not applying. So what we will do, just close it, and it will again ask here, the current style has been modified. Do you want to save your changes? Click on yes. So it will be saved automatically. Then to change those textile here, we will have to create some dimension styles. So you can also choose dimension style from here. Click here on annotation and here is dimension style. Click there. Then to create new dimension style, click here on new. Then name it as 30. Click on continue. Then select here textile as 30, okay. Then click on new, name it as minus 30, continue. Then select minus 30 textile, click on okay, click on close. Then select all these dimensions, then click here on annotation, click here and select 30, press escape. So here these dimensions got aligned perfectly. Then for these two dimensions, select them, click here, click here, click on minus 30, press escape. So these dimensions also got aligned perfectly. So this isometric drawing is completed. In the next tutorial, we will start learning 3D modeling in AutoCAD. So please like, share and subscribe. Thanks for watching. We will again meet in next tutorial.